第二个藏传佛教在汉地，因为这里的有些教授所谓的洞房，指的是在汉地，流行的情况呢，实际上，汉地可能跟其他有些地方是不同的，它的文化底蕴呢，儒释道，本身都有这样的，这种信仰，再加上呢，不管是唐朝也好，宋朝、元朝，还有明朝和清朝，在这个高层的一些这个人士当中的话，对藏传佛教都有来往和学习和这样的一种这个传统，就每一个朝代都有这样的。
And then I want to talk about the Han region in China. So here you mean the Eastern world. Basically, I think you refer to the Han region or China. So I think when we talk about the Han region, so they have different cultural backgrounds. So in the Han region, we have the Confucianism and Taoism and Buddhism serve as the main three branches of the Chinese culture. And also when we look back to the history, in the Tang Dynasty, Song Dynasty, Yuan Dynasty, Ming Dynasty, and Qing Dynasty, there are lots of upper classes, so people with high social status, they also study and communicate with the Tibetan Buddhism. This was a tradition.
尤其是元朝，还有明朝、清朝，这几个朝代的话，应该说，藏传佛教，在汉地的各个层次、各个这种不同的人群当中呢，都这个比较兴盛。
And especially in the Yuan and Ming and the Qing Dynasty, I think Tibetan Buddhism actually at that time was very popular among different groups of people.
当中，他们从真正的理论上，系统上了解的话呢，我觉得是近代，在上个世纪，应该是四五十年代的时候呢，像汉传佛教当中的，冷海，法尊，还有呢，是贡嘎罗喇等等，就是有很多的了不起的高僧大德，就是，入藏这个求学，并且呢，就藏传佛教的许多的显宗和密宗的经典和论点呢，就是翻译成汉语。
And then I think from the very theoretical and systematic perspective, the real, Tibetan Buddhism in China start around the time of the recent times, so basically the 1940s or some 1950s. And at that time, there are several great masters, Master Nenghai, Fazun, Gongga, and Ruona. They went to Tibet to study, and they translated lots of the both the Sutrayana and Tantrayana from Tibetan into Chinese.
那么之后呢，应该，20世纪的七八十年代开始呢，就藏传佛教，再次的应该汉地很多的，不管是在寺院当中，还是在家群体当中呢，都有就比较跟以往不同的，有些学者呢，就认为是这是一个新时代那样的一种，特别流行，特别是。就是市场的一种这个，就宗教吧，就是有些学者还认为是现在藏传佛教，成为一个世界的宗教，但我倒是并不是这么认为，但不管怎么样，这个信仰藏传佛教的人呢，就是也比较多。
And then around the time of 1970s and 1980s, I think Tibetan Buddhism again, gaining popular again, both in the temples and also among the lay practitioners in China. And lots of scholars describe this period as the new age of the Tibetan Buddhism. And some of them even think that Tibetan Buddhism is a world religion, but I don't think so. But this is a time where it's getting flourished again.
但在这个同时呢，汉地，也有很多所谓的假活佛，什么假上师，各种各样的这种形象，乱象也不断的在出现。
But at the same time, in the Han region, there are lots of problems. They have the fake guru and the fake tugu, so they have very complicated phenomenon in China.
就是讲一些佛法的课，就是除了一些出去在路上啊，或者这些以外的话呢，基本上是没有间断的课。有时候呢，就觉得是很多现在佛教徒对佛教的经和论点理论上实际上都比较了解，就很有这种好的感觉。有时候呢，就看到各种现象的时候呢，就心里也不是一个滋味。
Around the time of 1980s, from this past 30 years, every day I taught Buddhism in Chinese to a large groups of people without any stopping. And I mean, in case I was abroad and then I stopped, but otherwise I constantly giving teaching to the Chinese Buddhist, and sometimes I feel very good because nowadays lots of Chinese Buddhists, they know a lot about the sutras, and so I feel very good. But sometimes when I see some not very good phenomenon, sometimes I don't feel very good.
这几年以来确实有很多年轻人，包括有一些什么所谓的比较高层的人也好。 还有一些演艺界的人也好，大家都对佛教有这种兴趣，主要的原因呢，我是想他们对佛教有兴趣呢，其实是并不是没有什么原因的。现在尤其是特别现实主义的这样的一个非常复杂的社会当中，应该有原因的。
And it's especially nowadays, Tibetan Buddhism became very popular among the youth and among the high educated people, and also some actors and actresses, they also very interested in this. But I think this age is a time of realism. So they study Buddhism, they follow Buddhism, they have a reason.